I've heard people from different places across the country and some foreign countries, and they can see their own lives or the lives of loved ones through this journey. And this journey is about living with Alzheimer's. I saw this journey as a window for the baby boom generation, that they could look through my window and see things in their own lives in this disease that we need to bring out of the closet and talk more openly about.
Imagine, if you will, a terrorist organization announcing tomorrow that had a bioweapon that was going to infect 80 million people by 2030, 11 years from now. And can you imagine the globe's response to that proposition?
This is a quiet thief in the night that relentlessly robs from the patient the sense of identity, personality, and ultimately the very essence of self.
If we don't do anything by 2050, minimally 14 million patients in this country, it will single-handedly wipe out our healthcare system.
There are millions of people who are undiagnosed, who are walking around on the path to Alzheimer's.
Greg O'Brien has Alzheimer's, a lifetime journalist. He's written a book about what he calls embedded in Alzheimer's.
Anyone who's ever chatted with Greg knows that that's a real conversation, and it's heart to heart, and it's soul bared, and it's funny, and it's irreverent, and it's loving, and just brutally honest.
I believe that God, first of all, has a sense of humor, and God will talk to you in language that you just understand. Mm-hmm. I want a God like Coach Belichick. Do your job.
Well, as I tell the Patriot haters, if you lived in New England and had enjoyed six Super Bowls, you'd probably be rooting for the Patriots too.
Right, so there, okay, now I lost my train of thought.
Well, we're
Have we met before? Greg O'Brien, damn pleased to
Good
meet
to
you.
Good to meet you, Greg.
Alzheimer's, it's like having a sliver of your brain shaved every day. 60% of my short-term memory can be gone in 30 seconds. And every day is a fight for me. And
I put a stake in the ground as a journalist and said, we're going to start to talk about it.
What about the kids? Alzheimer's is about the kids. It's about your kids. My kids, my grandchildren, and your grandchildren. And that's why we have to marshal the forces to bring this out into the public, to bring Alzheimer's out of the closet into the public like we did cancer and AIDS.
I feel right now, and I know others in this journey feel, that we have one foot in the next realm and one foot here. And I'm just waiting for the Lord to pull me over to the next realm. And he keeps saying, not yet. I go, well, how about today? Not yet. We're not done.